Hello, my name is Abigail. I'm the closed captionist and transcriptionist here at Mesa Community College. You're probably here because you've just been told you need to add closed captions to your course videos. Typically, you will use YouTube Studio to add and edit captions. You will also be able to paste caption files from YouTube Studio directly into Canvas, which we'll get into later on. You will need three things for this process: the MP4 file of your video, a work account on YouTube, and a blank Google Doc or Word document. Step 1. Upload the MP4 file into YouTube. On your YouTube homepage, click on your account icon in the top right corner. Then, click on YouTube Studio, which will take you to your studio dashboard. On the top right corner of the page next to your account icon, click on Create. Then, click on Upload Videos and select Files. This will bring up the files on your computer. Once you choose the MP4 file of your video, you will be given a few settings for the video: details, video elements, checks, and visibility. Under details, scroll down to the audience subheading and choose, "No, it's not made for kids." Click Show More at the bottom of the menu, scroll down to the language and caption certification subheading, and choose English from the drop-down menu for video language. Click Next. Under video elements and checks, you won't need to change or choose anything, so click Next for both. Under visibility, choose Unlisted. All this means is that someone can't access the video unless they have the link. Once you click Save, your video will begin to process. Depending on the length of the video, the captions may auto-generate in minutes or hours. Step 2. Edit the automatic captions. On the left-hand menu, click on Content and find the video you want to edit. If you hover over that video's row, you will see a pencil Details icon. Clicking on this takes you to several video settings, including the thumbnail, the title, and the subtitles. Scroll down and click on the subtitles setting on the right. Now, there's a couple of things you might see. If the automatic captions have not yet been generated, it will give you the following options: Upload File, Auto-Sync, Type Manually, and Auto-Translate. If you plan on typing the captions by hand rather than editing the automatic captions, then click Type Manually. Otherwise, if you want to edit the automatic captions, close the window and check back later to see if they have been generated. When you click on Subtitles and it shows the text in boxes with timings to the right of them, click on Edit as Text in blue on the top of the menu. YouTube may not generate the most accurate captions, but it has a fairly advanced timing feature. We'll go into why this feature is important in a moment. If you click on Subtitles and it shows the plain text with Edit Timings in blue above the text, you're on the right screen. At this point, there are a few things you need to keep in mind. Grammar is crucial for comprehension, and if punctuation or correct spelling is missing, captions are not as effective. So, make sure to read the captions while you're editing and check that they make sense. Also, pay attention to technical terminology in your captions. YouTube is not as advanced with catching industry-specific terms, so pay attention to the spelling and capitalization of these words specifically. You can save the captions by clicking Save Draft, or click Done if you want to go back and edit them later. As a precaution, you should copy and paste the text into a blank Google Doc or Word document every once in a while. Having that document also provides you with a complete transcript of your video. Step 3. Sharing your YouTube video or adding the captions to Canvas. Now that your captions are complete, all you have to do is share the YouTube link, which can be accessed quickly on the page with the video settings. Under the video preview, on the top right of the page is the link in blue, and you can click the Copy Link icon to the right of it. Some of you might have already put the video into Canvas and don't want to replace it with a new link. In that case, on your YouTube Studio dashboard, click on the Subtitles option on the left-hand menu. After clicking on the video, you will find the language titled English Video Language. If you hover over the Subtitles column, you will see a pencil Edit icon, a trash Delete icon, and an icon with three dots for Options. Click on the Options icon, Download, and then click on the option called .srt. This is the caption or subtitle file and contains both the text and the exact timings. Once the file is downloaded to your computer, you will add the SRT file to your Canvas video. Once you are on the page containing the video in Canvas, click Edit. Then click on the video and Video Options. A menu will pop up on the left, and under Closed Captions/Subtitles, select English from the drop-down menu. Underneath this drop-down menu, click on Choose Caption File. This will bring up the files on your computer, and you will choose the SRT file that goes along with that video. I want to address why I recommend editing captions through YouTube Studio, even if you plan on adding the captions to Canvas. As I mentioned, while YouTube is still not advanced enough to provide sufficient and accurate automatic captions, YouTube does have an intuitive timing feature. This means that it knows when to sync which piece of text at what exact time in the audio. Doing this manually would be inefficient and frustrating. Additionally, creating the captions and caption files through YouTube means that your captioned video exists on YouTube as well as Canvas. If your video is not appearing on or is having issues with Canvas, you can redirect students to the YouTube link instead. Thank you so much for watching this guide. Hopefully you now feel prepared and confident in your ability to add closed captions to your videos. There are also some resources in the video description if you have any other questions about the captioning process. Good luck and have a great day.